a nice spring day, as I said, and we all get up to get out and enjoy the atmosphere of the Lord. As I said, wouldn't you like to be a tree down by the water, where the roots go down deep and are able to receive the nourishment of the water by the grace of God through the Holy Spirit. So it is with Christ. As he says, abide in me, and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. For my brothers and my sisters, many of us are trying to abide within ourselves. Many of us have arrived with taking on selfish attitudes to where we think that we can abide within ourselves. But I have learned that that is not the case. But when I had looked for answers within myself, I can find out that I did not have the answers within myself. And when I went out of myself to look for the answers and look for them in the wrong people, then I got the wrong answers that produced the wrong results. And that made more trouble for me than I had a prior time. So it is good, my brothers and sisters, to know that you must abide in the Lord. I am the vine. You are the branch. He who abides in me, and I in him, bear much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. Without Christ, you can't do anything. I don't care who you are, where you came from, what you think you know, you don't know. I mean, I see people growing up and growing old, and dying in old age, never to have learned their true purpose for why they had lived. Growing up, growing old, and dying in old age, never to have learned their true purpose for why they had lived. Because there is much distraction between the TVs, the radio, the clubs, there is much distraction where you never get time to get away from yourself in order to get into yourself. You got some people that go home, they never get to know who they are because they got to have the radio on, or they got to have the TV on, or they got to be talking to somebody all the time. Sometimes you need to turn off the radio, turn off the TV, and turn into yourself that you get to know who you are. You got to get to know who you are within yourself, my brothers and my sisters. Otherwise, you'll have problems. If you abide in me and the word abides in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. Thus saith the Lord, my God. My brothers and my sisters, it is good to be good, but it is not good to be good for nothing. But you have many people that are good for nothing, that do no good. And they are as nightmares. And sometimes you see nightmares in the daytime. You have people that come out in the day that usually go out at night. I call them vampires. They go out at night and they sleep all day. But once in a while, you see a nightmare come out in the daytime when normally they'd be asleep. Because when we sleep, they're running. And when we're running, they're asleep. Vampires. But I say that not to be hypocritical in one sense. Well, there were times that I used to run in the night. In the night and thought I had the light, but I was in darkness. But thank God for Jesus, who allows one to arrive up out of the night and into the light. Now I come out in the daytime, and I sleep in the nighttime. And that is the natural order of things. I come out in the day and sleep at night. But my brothers and my sisters, I tell you, you never know who will hear the word and who will receive it, and how a transformation may arrive upon them. So it is not for me to judge anyone, but just to give the word, that the word may be received. For faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. And who's to know who is who but God? So every day you must go out and do what you need to do, and do it in the light, that the light shines down upon you, and do not do it in the dark. Because what's done in the dark will come to light. It's a matter of time. What's done in the dark will come to light. It's a matter of time. So my brothers and my sisters, I say this to you. Do not look at me to look at me, because I have nothing to say. But look at me to look at the Holy Spirit, because it has everything to say. So when I come to you, I do not come in the exterior of my physical appearance. I come to you with the interior of the makeup of God that he's given me to give to you. So be careful not to be careless, my brothers and my sisters, because I know there are many forces out here. As I said before, I will say again, all you are is a puppet. And the devil's disciples are the puppeteers. And the devil is the puppet master. And the puppet master goes out and tells the puppeteers, which are his disciples, his fallen angels, what he wants the puppets to do. And then the puppeteers come to you because you are the puppet. And he has you out there smoking that crack cocaine. He has you out there drinking and getting drunk, running behind every hole you find out in the streets. He has you out there destroying your life, trying to take you to hell, because he knows that's where he's going. Because God prepared hell for the devil and his angels. But I guess misery loves company. And since the devil is miserable and his angels are miserable, you're going to be his company. If you don't straighten up your life, you wind up being his company. And you'll go straight down to hell right along with him. You'll wind up being his company. But now that you have a chance to hear the word, and truth cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of the Lord. Now that you have a chance, you have a chance to change. Change your mind. I know it's hard, because when you hear something foreign, you don't want to receive it because it creates opposition. But opposition creates change. So what you got to learn to do is allow the opposition to introduce the change. When I get up in the morning and I go down to the gym, I do push-ups. Because I'm doing push-up, I'm opposing gravity, and I create an opposition. And opposition creates change. My muscles get bigger, and I become stronger. So it's good to have opposition. There's nothing wrong with having opposition. Opposition creates change. So if I'm saying something that sounds foreign to you, if I say I'm saying something that sounds as if you don't want to hear it, sometimes, my brothers and sisters, it's good that you don't walk in darkness, because you might stumble and you might fall. It's good to have a little light on in your house. Somebody might have put an obstacle in your way to where you normally may be able to walk in the dark. This particular night, you can't walk there because somebody put something in your way to cause you to stumble and fall. So my brothers and my sisters, without no further ado, I say, get my books. You'll see me on Twitter. I'm on YouTube. I'm on Facebook. I'm everywhere. Get my books, watch my videos. It's good edification. It's good to put good food in the atmosphere that you can eat. Get the good food of the ministers, of the ministries, who's preaching the good word of God. Amen.